Turn up my swag to infinity. This dude hard, bruh. About time, nigga. Now I'm about to bust your ass.
First open back in 1975.
Let's go.
Look inside the iconic Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Atlanta Falcons and the New Orleans Saints. With fall around the corner, football is back, America, and we're underway on EA Sports. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20.
Let me see what he come out in. My match, whatever formation he come out in. I know he going to come out running. He got the rookie. He got Harris start. We both from Bama.
Trying to get it to the outside, trying to get
Harris,
to the
running back.
Not a whole lot of room there, but there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Nigga, I don't want to talk on the phone. I'm playing against your ass.
Now Harris. And an alley to run. And he'll find some space up about the 25.
Yo, what's up, bro?
6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half.
Huh?
You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback. And no better way to do it.
They're moving like robots.
Winning game early.
Third play of this opening drive is
about to what?
Into third and three.
Hold up. What you said? This nigga gonna run a play when I'm trying to FaceTime. Hell no, bro. I ain't about to FaceTime your ass shit. That's why your running back hurting up, bitch.
We're gonna get whistles and a stop. A man down on the return. Boy, not what you want to see in quarter one.
He wanna tell me to FaceTime it, but then won't run a play. How you gonna do that, K?
And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're gonna line up to go for this thing on fourth down.
My man moving just like that too. Damn, my internet, nigga. My internet don't control yours. Give me that ball back, dude. Yeah.
He did. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out.
Started over.
The Saints are going to get it back and in great
Come on,
shape.
Man. I know. I waited about an hour and a half, 2 hours for your ass. If it's like that this time, bro, we playing. Fuck it. Cause your men moving the same way mine moving. I don't have a problem. I'm good. I'm serious, nigga. I'm good. Your ass the one talking about fucking your men moving like fucking robots and shit. I ain't got time for that shit, man. I start this bitch over one time for your ass.
Why these dudes got these goddamn excuses, Kate? Where do the excuses come from, man? Man, his men moving like robots. It's a game. They not gonna move real life. What the fuck? I came on top of the building, yeah, my we had a plan. We came on top of the building, yeah, my we never ran. Down there, thought that I had a plan. It's gonna be the same old thing. And I had just stopped him on fourth down. And I got the ball back on the 30-yard line. On his 30. But he won't restart it then. I got the hotel when I step out. Yeah, your boy got a doorman. I go to nightclub for the. Yeah, they call me the madman. I ain't no madman. I just go crazy, man. Seemed like everything started getting more interesting with this dude, man. Every time. There's always something. I just waited about an hour and a half to 2 hours for your ass. Now you want to restart.
Here's a look inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in New Orleans.
Could have been almost to the second quarter.
Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL.
And then I'm receiving the ball. I was kicking the ball at first. What happened?
You name it. This crowd is ready. As their guys get set to match up between the Atlanta Falcons and the New Orleans Saints. That's fielded in the end zone. Boy, shifts past him.
Oh, yeah. Return. Return that hoop. I'm on his 41-yard line on the kickoff return. Come on, man. Just because you want to restart, I'm about to go ham on your ass.
They'll run. This is Melvin Gordon. And he's going to be down about the 30.
Just got introduced to Melvin Gordon, nigga.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
A nice run here early on. It did take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. And he'll be dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about 4.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down.
And then I gave that boy Melvin Gordon his jersey number from college. Get that boy that number 5. Looking sweet.
On second down, they'll run with Gordon.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Truck that boy, Gordon.
A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
How about Gordon going ham?
Watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus the intensity.
How about Gordon going ham right now, Key?
So following the run by Gordon.
Already. I think I like 3 rushes for like 40-some yards.
First and goal, Melvin Gordon.
He trucking D-lineman and all, bro. No, he got 5 rushes for 36 yards.
This drive is pretty clear.
Bro, he trucking D-lineman. When he ain't much going fast.
The defense was at 5 straight runs.
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. He'll get it up the middle.
Leonard Fournette.
Call it a gain of a yard as they get.
Then I got Fournette coming right behind.
Third and goal. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
Put that in the end zone, you heard me? He can't stop the run. So when I start the pass, he ain't gonna know what the hell I'm doing. I'm gonna do the same formation. It took me a minute and 28 seconds to score. 7-0 already. Minute and 28 seconds, 7-0.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
Because he went back and he got it to where he could kick the ball off. That's what he did. Because when I was seeing the thing, his man was moving just like my man, bro. He full of some bullshit. Come that 3-receiver set. Let's go.
from the shotgun now.
Nigga, you can't do like me. You can't bust them like me. Not the zone inside, not on me.
To about the 21.
Not on me.
2 yards on the carry there.
Nah, homie, I'm on that.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs.
I about think he about to use my shit on me, K.
A little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Hey, let him try. He could try it by all means. I don't think it's going to be so successful for you. Because you know what I do? I play on the safety when they do that. Nigga, you're not going to bust no big run. You got one rush with your ball for 5 yards. He's switching running backs and shit, trying to switch them in. Nigga, I don't switch them in. They just automatically switch in when they get tired.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Nigga, I just missed your ass. I play that shit so perfectly, but I just missed his ass.
It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the
chains. His ass about to be 4th down and lost in yards.
But to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big 3rd down pickup to keep their drive alive.
From the shotgun.
Oh, yeah, come here. Oh, yeah. I'm about to bring that blitz in on your ass now. You want to do the inside zone? Let's go. Let's go.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second
caught
down.
That ball slipping in the backfield, kid. He just don't know, kid.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Now he'll look to throw.
Come here, Saints. You heard me?
He's taken down here by the Saints.
Now it's 3rd and 18. I'm playing back on your ass.
Right about the gamble, because
I ain't blitzing him again. Because he about to go deep now. He about to go deep. I know he is.
And when he comes at the quarterback,
he about to go straight across the middle with somebody. And he got Julio at tight end. My D lineman about to get there for me.
Off the play fake. He'll look to throw.
Oh, pick. What I said, K? What I said? K, what I just say? He about to go deep. He went deep to Julio, and I was on Jamal Adams. Pick all day. He about to get another little taste of Melvin Gordon. He going to get tired of Melvin Gordon. He going to get tired of Melvin Gordon, K. He said, man, my shit stopped completely. He texting. Come on, man, my shit stopped completely. What you mean your shit stopped completely?
New Orleans. They'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one. That
he talking about he feel like I'm doing some shit to win.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right?
Looks like nigga, how I'm going to control,
gate, as they would say, when you're
how I'm control your internet?
Means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace.
It ain't my fault. You use your phone as your internet to play the game, bro.
And that'll bring up a second and just
it ain't my fault.
Here.
Go get some internet. I told you. You say you make good money, bro. Go ahead. Go get you some internet and stop using your phone internet.
The 35 now at the 34-yard.
How about Xavier Howard hurt now?
Well, came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show.
How about Connor hurt now?
I believe
so. You know I'm gonna be going deep soon, right?
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10.
That's his starting corner.
Now Gordon on 1st down.
He wasn't even supposed to touch him. That was a big ass hole. That was a big ass hole. He wasn't even supposed to touch him.
Inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping.
Boom.
This big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through.
He gonna really think I'm gonna be running every time I go to his formation now.
Trying to pick up there is it'll leave him with a 3rd and about 4 more for 1st. Now Gordon, and he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup.
I just switched
there,
it up on him before he even seen it.
4th down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility.
Oh, he got intercepted. He got
And this return is going to be halted right around the 20.
I should have did something different. Instead of that shit.
But this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone
schemes. And he had
the
coverage.
And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one
really
comes right
bitch.
To him.
Coming out on the field and following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Sack! 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 Bradley Chubb!
Offensive coordinator, and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use your
do a play at your feet.
As this game goes on, I'm going to hit him with a screen soon.
You can come with a screen if you want. Hold up. Nigga, what just happened to my screen? My fucking screen just automatically went out. Nigga. There you go right there. And then nigga still didn't get the first and my screen went blank? Oh, come on, nut.
Back to throw here. He completes it to Julio Jones.
Fourth down.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength try to occupy some space.
He about to try to go for it. He's going to give me the ball right back.
The football, but not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Back to 99 Philly. Here we go.
Yes, give me the ball. Give me the ball. I want the ball. I had messed up the first time, but the second time I messed up. Now I'm about to make up for that. I'm talking about this dude can't go nowhere, K. He haven't passed the 50 yet, K.
A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
He'll look to throw. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time.
Nuh-uh. Ain't
often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start
right
back
there.
To
what
the backfield for
right
him.
There?
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance
at?
To get up there and stop him.
No,
right
I mean,
there.
That's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but
if
when he gets that kind
in
of
the
start
right
defense, and comes
somebody
through
to smoke
clean,
his ass.
Oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
If he in that defense, I'm about to smoke him.
Green, 39!
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
Oh! Touchdown! Touchdown, rookie!
Zone,
touchdown rookie. I called him out the slot.
In for the score.
I called it out, King. Called
lead.
That bitch out. That safety came drop down. Boy, I got happy as fuck.
It's still tough to think about throwing a rookie quarterback right
I
to
missed
the
that kick.
Week one. But guess what? He handled the fire awfully well and threw his first touchdown pass.
I think I caught that bitch and dove in the end zone. It's 13-0 right now.
Setting out to kick this one away and
second quarter, 4 minutes and a half.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down.
Yeah, but not knowing I ain't listen to his ass. That's why he ain't texting
them. As their offense heads back onto the field. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
I know he going to Julio.
A lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so.
Oh, no, he ran that bitch, but hey, you ain't going nowhere.
Aggressive on offense, and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things.
Okay, this ain't going to be no game.
Maybe play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Okay, this ain't going to be no game.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he goes across the
22. He got 6 rushes for 22 yards.
On the ground there, they're now left with 3rd and 6.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, but some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down.
How this nigga got that shit? They had two people right
first
there.
To the new season for him, and he picks up the first. So first and 10.
He about to go to Julio, Greedy. Greedy, he coming to Julio. I got you out there by yourself. Do your thing.
They'll look to throw here on first down.
Yes, sack.
As he releases it,
I hit his ass. He was trying to go down too. He was trying to go down. He don't know. I got Lattimore and Greedy out there. Them boys, top corners. That boy broke Greedy tackle. How? That dude. Come on, you serious? Body to body.
And the Falcons draw a bit closer.
That's the only thing he got, K. A deep route.
A simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down.
Promise you, that's all he got, K.
As a player, but I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receiver.
Come on, practice.
That meant fly route, go. Look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
That'll be taken in the end zone.
Nigga, my kick returner, my rookie, he's going ham right now.
Now the Saints, they trot their offense out here.
For real, for real. Not your receivers.
They'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. And he's got a good gain of 7.
I got 12 rushes for 64 yards.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits. And the increases on
my first.
It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I've
ooh, bump and run, bump and run, bump and run.
To go ahead and run the football in that situation.
Go bump and run if you want. They got 2 fast ass motherfuckers on the end.
They go play action here on first down.
Shit, he blitzed. Them niggas was open.
Well, that's the second Kate. Time he's been sacked so far in the first
Samuel
half.
Brown was gone.
Designs on having a big year, on going anywhere. They got to find a way to keep him upright so he can throw the football.
Now a shotgun snap as they look to throw.
Samuel burned him. He burned him. He burned him. That's what I'm talking about, Samuel. You want to go bomb for bomb? I got bomb for bomb for you. Let's go. 13-7, and I'm on his 13-yard line with 2 minutes left. It's about to be a 2-minute warning, and I'm about to run the rest of this in there with Melvin
Gordon. When it's one-on-one and the ball's in the air like that.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Yeah.
To go here in the first half. We're back to New Orleans after this.
Flag. Offside. Let's go. That boy ain't got no kind of discipline on that D-line. My men ain't even put their hands on the ground yet. You hear me, kid? Them boys ain't even put their hands on the ground yet. And coach me. Boys ain't got no discipline, man.
Second and two now. The penalty leaves him in pretty good shape.
You know what his excuse gonna be, right? Man, I'm both moving like robots.
Following the penalty, here's Gordon.
Touchdown! That's what I'm talking about, Gordon. How about Gordon truck this week 5 yards into the end zone?
Melvin Gordon, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Saints add on to the.
How about truck this week 5 yards into the end zone?
And there you go. Nothing really too complex.
He not going to stop Gordon, man.
Let him run it in. They get it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking. Needs good tackling on that play.
Gordon going to have over 100 yards this game. Before the half.
Taking about 7 yards deep.
Nigga, you ain't going nowhere.
And he'll return this one all the way onto the other side of the field.
Now that's can't return kicks
that
like
warms
me.
The heart of a special teams coach. He'll be pushing us next time, Brandon, to make sure his guys are introduced in the starting lineup.
Go three.
These guys
three.
Have such an influence on every game. The unsung heroes. Remember, they have their own meetings, their own practice time, heck, their own spot on the bench in order to be ready to play each and every week.
That ball dropped that thing. That's what I'm talking about, greedy. But lay that lumber on that ball. That ball don't catch. Greedy knocked the fuck out that boy, man. That boy Odell tried to go across the middle catching something, man. That's out of bounds. That boy Tua everywhere. Tua throwing that bitch everywhere. He got pressure in his face.
One thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have.
Sack! Sack! Sack!
Back at the 47.
Fourth and 15.
Raekwon McMillan. He's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of five.
Timeout. I'm going to call a timeout myself. Got a minute and a half left. I want the ball because I'm trying to get over 100 yards. And I'm about to have. And I want him to think about his decision because he's giving the ball on his 48 if he don't make it. He's still going for it. All right. Let's go cover four.
Now, the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it here. He's going to go for a big play downfield.
He dropped it. He dropped it. I just said that, King.
Incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there.
Them boys hitting, King. That boy Greedy hitting, King.
Great shape.
Greedy out there hitting, King. On his 48.
Busy night continues for Gordon as he gets it here.
Gordon got 79 yards rushing right now.
Able to get him down. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
What's the old expression? 3 yards in a cloud of dust. In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play. Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level.
And Buck can't stop him.
He just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat, and we said, nah, man.
He got 95 yards rushing.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. It's a gain of 5, and now the question, will the offense stay out there on 4th and 1? Here's Gordon.
He got over 100 yards right here. He got 100 right here. He already got 100, kid. 21 rushes for 100 yards.
Very solid fourth down conversion and defensively pure frustration. They run it here with Gordon. And he takes it down.
He got 113.
And now we won't see a play on
16 seconds left.
Instead, as they stop it with 16 seconds to go.
Okay, I'm about to go slant on him.
A chance to really cap off a big first half here.
I'm on his 10-yard line, okay.
Looking to throw.
Oh! You had it. He a rookie, dude. He gonna drop it if he get hit. He had that big kid. Okay, I was so happy. That nigga had that bit. I don't want to run it right now because that time gonna run out if I don't get in the end zone. Well, if I get tackled, that bitch is gonna run out.
Now back to throw.
Oh yeah, Brown! Touchdown! And he got hit! That's what I'm talking about, baby! Touchdown, you heard me?
26-7.
He threw it in traffic. Two defenders, bro. He got hit. Why he was catching the ball?
Something really to take into the lockers here.
It's 27-7 now.
That's good on the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to an even 20.
That boy say, what the fuck, bro?
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and
he said he's standing right there. Yeah, you hit him, but that dude catching traffic at 98, man.
That's fielded in the end zone.
That's what they don't understand. You ain't hitting that edge, bro.
So we all right, we will save the
and you get the ball right back. But hey, it ain't gonna help you now.
All right, coach.
Cause you still scuffling.
Welcome everyone back for quarter number three. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And it'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if
I would have made him fumble on a kick return. That boy would be pissed off right now.
The 21-yard line. Now the Falcons
but Judy just took a big ass
right
hit.
To head back onto the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
This is a
yes, man. This is that boy one on one to Odell Marshawn Lattimore. He bagged that bitch out your hand, Odell. Ah, shit. Oh, shit, bud. He only got nothing but deep routes right now, kid. That's all he got. Get that out of there. You can't do that on Marshawn Lattimore. That boy's name ain't over. Oh, man. Come on, bruh.
This defense is continuing to
dude, come on. I'm not going to be stupid and press and do man press on them. They already got good man coverage and zone coverage.
Eventually, that becomes man on man, and you got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make the play on the football.
That, he's taken down.
That boy got full for 11, 103 yards, one touchdown, one pick. And he just getting over 100 yards right now. I got over 100 yards, and I ain't hardly throwing. But I ain't got over 100 yards yet. I got 90 yards. He got actually 82 yards passing and 24 yards rushing. I got 117 rushing and 90 passing.
But able to slip across the 35.
How about quarterback rating gonna be garbage?
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
He went and put somebody else in the game. That's what he did.
Back to throw.
Sack. Okay, them two middle linebackers, Raekwon and Kawhi Alexander. Man, them boys cause hell. Sack. That boy got another sack. He just got a sack. He got three sacks and three tackles. You can't stop him.
That is his third sack here tonight.
Okay, let's go back.
That dude getting back there, kid.
Schooling comes to the front. What's that old saying?
He can't do nothing, kid.
Forget the lessons of history are doomed to repeat them.
Kid, he can't do nothing. I'm rushing six. He block. He got five blocking. I'm rushing six. He got five blocking. That's another sack. My rookie got a sack. It's 4th and 34. What you gonna do, young fella? Thank you. You finally gonna punt. He finally punting, kid. He learned.
The punter Bosher on now as he gets this one away. Taken from just outside the 30. Fancy footwork at the 45.
Basically.
An excellent return that time. 26 yards.
See, I'm about to go with my rookie again on that same play. I got my rookie to touchdown. I'm going back with that play. If he give it to me, I'm taking it.
Getting ready for their first possession.
If he give it to me, he's crazy for letting me get it.
Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches.
This receiver got 98. It looked like he playing man for one.
Emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you.
Oh, he beat. Rookie got another touchdown, yo.
And he'll take it into the end zone for the
And he was playing on the safety. He was playing on the safety. 33-7.
Making quite a splash with his second touchdown of his NFL debut. And the Saints.
It's past halftime. I could miss an extra field. I could miss an extra kick and still be happy with this dude, man.
And no good. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone.
That boy's stupid. You had a whole wide open lane. What you gonna make a move for?
Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set
Bruh,
to take over.
I got number pressure coming in his face every play now, kid. Every play. No breaks. I'm rushing six. You got five blocking. Let's go.
What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get,
and that's caught inside.
Come on, Greedy. You got to be on him a little bit better. You was on him, but you got to be on him. You're already playing back. Come on, Greedy. Don't give up on me like that.
He's got their only
Y'all
got
to get pressure up there. I'm about to get on Julio. No, I want Julio. I want Blitz.
And sometimes you just don't have it. Maybe it's just lukewarm. But you go to that guy and try and turn it hot. Try and get things going.
Oh, he went to Julio. Pick. Pick. Jamal Adams got his second pick of the game. K, I ain't playing no games, K. K, I ain't playing no games with him, K.
It seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's
Kate,
his second interception of the game.
He gonna learn, Kate. You can't just throw that bitch out there on me.
Especially when it comes to defending the pass. It's all about position Kate. And technique. And this is fantastic. Kate, both fronts there.
This dude ain't about to last.
They'll start on the ground. This is Gordon on first down.
He ain't about to last.
Give him five on the carry.
Brown got a touchdown. The rookie got two touchdowns. I got to get Samuel a touchdown.
You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Takes it to the 26. Just
Melvin Gordon got 24 rushes for 119 and a touchdown.
You know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was
okay. I'm going for it on fourth down.
The offense gonna stay out there.
I'm about to get this. I'm about to get Ingram a first down right quick. Or I might get the rookie going across. I don't know who I'm gonna go with. It depends on who's gonna be open. He's open. The rookie. The rookie was open. The new, the other rookie, not the same rookie. The other rookie.
Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there.
Okay, he don't know what to do, kid.
To the 35 now as they come up.
Every play I do, I'm being successful, kid. Every play.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
Every play, I'm successful.
To about the 39 here. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Samuel's about to get this play right here, kid.
Room that he had in the first half go because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some.
Oh no, Brown.
Appears, at least on this drive.
Brown got it.
Inside the 30.
Man, I'm 6 for 8 for 192 yards passing and 3 touchdowns and 1 pick.
That one goes for 36 yards.
Kate, I sound like you, bro.
Falcon territory now. Here's first and 10.
I sound like you, kid.
25 yard line.
Hey, Consistency is the key.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage.
I'm about to hit Melvin Gordon out the backfield. Melvin Gordon, have fun.
From his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
And the hit
jar. You're supposed to catch that one, Melvin.
It's incomplete.
You're supposed to catch that. He didn't catch it with his eye. Go the other way, y'all. I'm about to try to hit my tight end.
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, what credit to the defense for a shot?
Samuels. Okay, Samuels about to get this bitch. And he blitzing. I can see it. So I'm about to set up Melvin Ingram to block. He is blitzing, like I thought. Oh, Samuel. I said Samuel, right? He got one. It's about to be 40-7. Third quarter with a minute and 37 left.
You and I can join this quarterback in the zone he's in.
It's about to look like that game you played against the Jaguars. Look, Nut calling me right now. Yo!
And that will extend this big lead.
Son.
The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away.
Son. I'm not going outside the tackle. I'm going inside the tackle every rep.
It'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 20.
Are you playing on him? If you playing on him,
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate.
You can't go deep on me like that, though, bro. I got DBs backed up, bro. Say.
The only thing that matters is part two, right?
Say. I got some fucked up shit that happened with me.
And finish off the drive. That does him no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Now, finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Try to shake off the interception for the last drive. He'll look to throw. Caught on the right side by Jones. The completion.
That boy pissed off, Nike.
They'd love to just strike back in touchdown.
That boy pissed, Nike.
So be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath. Settle down and relax a little bit.
Pick! Another pick! Marshawn Lattimore! He can't say nothing about this, kid. He can't say nothing about that. He just throwing that bitch out there, kid. Okay, he's just throwing that bitch out there. I got my DBs just sitting back there waiting. They playing, already playing off on the receiver 10 yards, K. I got my cornerbacks playing back 10 yards. Why wouldn't you run slants? Right, K? I mean, I'm playing back 10 yards.
Way forward
here for
a good
I'm trying to get Melvin Gordon 200 yards rushing this game.
5 yards
I think I'm going to get it.
Good pickup on first down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second.
He got 130 right now, kid.
Solid gain on that play.
Just a couple on the pickup there. And now
he ain't bringing them corners up.
I know the
yeah, I still got a whole nother quarter.
That he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
The ball's still a few inches shy of the marker after the 3-yard run, so now a little soul searching on fourth down.
Gone! All right, now, lucky 56.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And
that is oh, he caught it. It should have been a fumble, if anything. It was fourth and inches. I should have ran it with Melvin Ingram, though. I ain't tripping. I'm up on him. I can try shit. I'm just trying shit on him, kid. I know he desperate right now, kid. He desperate right now, kid. He needs something.
An offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments.
He running them crossing
the
routes.
Coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
I mean, you think he might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Back now here live in New Orleans.
Okay, he just got over the half field just now. A very one-sided affair. He's just getting over half field. It's the full quarter. On first down. Back to throw now on first down. Greedy, go get it, Greedy. Knock that out that boy hands. Come on, man. You can't put that ball down on the other side and think he gonna get loose on Greedy. Come on, man. You serious? You know, things started out poorly in this game. He put him on the other side to think he was going to get loose on Greedy. All that does is embolden a secondary. Get that out of there. You can't run him across the middle and think he's going to get loose on Greedy. He playing the inside the whole way. Come on, man. I got him directed. This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it. They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that. He just got that because I clicked on him and got on. I fucked up. I fucked that up. He would have been stuck with. He ain't scored until the fourth quarter. He scored the first quarter, then. No, I think first or second quarter, and then the fourth quarter. However it went. It don't matter. I'm busting his ass.
Did he complete the process of the catch? All the way through, all the way to the ground. Ball doesn't hit the ground without control in his hands.
And you got a 2-point conversion. So it's 40 to 15 now. It's not as bad, but it's still bad.
He hits the big target for the 2-point try. Defenses hate those.
And he's not even kicking on sides.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety that doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the
what kind of, yeah.
But he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such.
Nigga, I should have brought it all the way back around. Fuck! That would have been touchdown. On a kickoff.
Ready to go back to work here. The outcome of this one, well, we know who's going to win it. It's just all window dressing.
I might see if I can get Leonard Fournette popping now. If I get Leonard Fournette popping, it's crazy. Player, broadcaster.
Well, I'm not going to go to the player part because when I think blowout.
Because you won every game as a player.
Come on, Leonard. Come on, Leonard.
To go back to those memories, but, you
let's
know,
go, Leonard.
College football, I saw a game that,
let's go, Leonard.
Put 70. I actually saw it happen twice. A team put 70 on their opponent.
Oh, Leonard Fournette just got loose.
17 season, I saw one of those changing of the guard games where a team that hadn't been very good before.
Okay, this boy in trouble. He let Leonard Fournette get loose too.
Who had been ruling their division,
and that's when you earn your paycheck.
Fournette get loose too, okay? Shit.
What's going on out there and how it all happened?
Well, obviously that begs the question: what game was it?
That was Seattle hosting.
Fuck! If I would have never spent, I would have had nothing but green grass.
Their second meeting of the season, and the Rams turned it around from the first one and blew out the Seahawks. Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Pushing forward for three.
Leonard Fournette got 6 rushes for 21 yards.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
They'll try and run for it with Fournette.
Oh, get it! Yes! I've got 7 for 35.
And they'll get 14 yards out of it and a fresh set of downs.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on a third down, we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball. You often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. They'll look to throw here. Flushed out, and he can't get rid of it.
I had Leonard Fournette open, too.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
It's third and long. It's true. It's true. It's true. Oh, man.
They'll set up to throw. And a throw here that's complete. And he'll be brought down. It looks like right at the 40.
I'm going for it. It's fourth down.
Good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4.
Fuck it.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like.
I'm gonna give the rookie another shot at getting a touchdown. Okay.
Try and hit your receiver on the
run. I'm on a 40-yard line, so I'm gonna give him another shot at.
Get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first.
Oh!
They're gonna look to throw. Into double coverage and it's intercepted.
Damn. He got
me.
Oh, he subbed in the rookie DB. No, the second-year DB. That's what he did. Oh, he on the one-yard line, Kate? He on the one-yard line? Kate, he on the one-yard line.
those situations. All right, fourth down. Where's the ball? Where would we get the ball? But instinct takes over, and when it's in the air, they just go and get it. So it's hard to get on him for intercepting it, but the smart play would have been what you suggested. Knock it down and take over in a deeper position.
Let's go! Let's go! We got pressure coming at you, Nick Bond.
But the best quarterbacks, they'll miss on 40% of their throws somewhere in that neighborhood, similar to a great hitter in baseball who's going to fail 7 out of 10 times and still have a great year. In this case, you want perfection, but way better that it hits the ground instead of going to an opposite color jersey.
That'll go for a gain of 13, helping big time to get away from that end zone. First down. They'll look to throw. He completes it to Jones.
He thinks he about to get it. He thinks about to have it all the time now. I went to, I could switch the cover too.
The first down completion.
They really love to get him into one-on-one opportunities, and this is one way. Work him out of the slot and create a mismatch. Who's going to cover him? Corner, safety, linebacker? He's got a way to beat all of those positions.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. That'll put him over 150 yards receiving now. Quite a ball game and a first down. He'll drop to throw. He finds his target, Beckham.
Come on, you serious? This man dove in the air to try to bat the ball, and he ain't touching.
Another first down as well. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this when he's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove.
Sack! It doesn't matter how we get pressure in that boy's face every rip.
To be in that groove right now.
Bradley Chubb hurt. I hear. What happened?
Something out of the bag of tricks, but it's incomplete and now second down.
Detroit!
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10.
Jay!
Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does, that ball going five receiver sets all day. Let's go.
Come from a long distance and have a chance to affect the pass.
Going deep downfield for Ross.
Pick!
For the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off down near the five.
Get that block for me. Yeah, keep going.
And they will
man, I got it all the way on his 42. I've caught it pick on the 10-yard line. We don't want you getting hurt no more, Chubb. Where Leonard Fournette at, man? I want Leonard Fournette to at least try to get up to get the rest of these yards, man. Let him get loose. He already got loose for a little bit. Let him get loose again.
Now flags
all sides.
I think
let's go. Neutral zone fraction. Let's go. Give
so
me some yards. Y'all want enough for that to get them? Give them to me.
Then. Don't move.
Cause I'm sure you're about to get them.
Until the ball moves.
So this helps to start a drive. After the penalty, it'll be first and five.
Over.
The penalty, it's Fournette.
There we go, Fournette. How about got 9 rushes for 46 yards, Kate?
10-yard pickup and it moves the chains.
And Brandon, this is where it pays to have a big
he can't stop the run on a pass, kid.
Especially in the fourth quarter when you've got the lead, your ability to not just wear people down, but close games out.
They keep it with Fournette on first down. Down right
40 to 15. Oh, shit. Fournette just got hurt.
You want to see Leonard Fournette very slow to get
he probably bruised.
Hate to see this. Week one I'm of the season. So we'll be back.
But I got my boy Melvin Ingram in the backfield.
Now the handoff comes to Gordon.
I still got some extra yards. That boy got 31 rushes for 135. He just got a bruise. He got a bruise real.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before.
That boy said, "You really think you're doing something, kid?" It looked like it.
On third down, this is Melvin Gordon. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. It'll be a gain of 4, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a fourth down now.
Well, forget knowing where the first down line was. This defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. And a lot of times that is one-on-one. And if you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
That is inside the
five. The rookie?
Can't quite get there.
Hold up. Is the rookie going to get his fourth touchdown?
Collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up
Kate,
first and goal.
If my rookie get his fourth touchdown, bro.
That one looks like he'll throw here and give him a
touchdown.
Six. It's caught for a touchdown.
Rookie guys, four touchdown, bro.
Continues. I think all teams probably like seeing that schedule for the first
time. The rook just got his fourth touchdown.
Good. We're at home. This is why you want to be home in week one. They're looking sharp.
47-15, Kate.
But there carries a little extra pressure with
29 seconds. 29 seconds left.
Protecting the home field, winning your home games is paramount in this league. So you go into it. Yeah, we want it.
And then he on live, kid.
Prove it.
Had two sides to that coin, and looking like they're going to
be here
in this one. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll get across the 20.
He about to throw it deep, and he about to throw a pick.
At about the 23-yard line.
I already see it coming, kid.
Coming out on the field.
And I'm about to go quarter.
Obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's,
three men deep.
Message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided.
Because I know he's coming out, isn't it?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo.
He dropped it because I popped him in his mouth. Kawhi Alexander popped Odell Beckham in the mouth, made him drop that bitch.
And never forget it because
you're not going to want that feeling.
That boy don't want to play no more. He ready to go home.
And who knows? You might meet up with his team again.
He'll look to throw.
Sack. With three-man rush. Sack. You got six men blocking. I got three men rushing. I still got a sack.
And that'll bring up a third down.
I'm going to call a timeout for you so you could see if you want to throw a deep bomb. It's 8 seconds.
Here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds.
And I'm going to call another timeout if you don't use all this time, kid.
50%, 4 for 9. This is third and 9. They'll set up a throw.
Sack.
He's taken down here by the Saints.
Sack, kid. Three men against six again. My D-line don't even have the top tier D-lineman out there, man. 83 and below. I only got one 83 DN out there, and he ain't much out there. It was a 77 defensive end and a 75 D tackle getting to him.
Down. They're going for it.
All right, now, look at 56.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield.
And that ball dropped it. Jamal Adams popped him this game. Jamal Adams popped that boy. He dropped that bitch. Ross may be fast, but he cannot catch. See, my rookie got a 98 speed.
We were into the regular season, the first game of the year. And you know, all eyes were watching this one. Everyone was excited. The football was back.
Say, Kate, 47 points, 220 yards passing, 188 yards rushing, four takeaways.
You got that right, but I love the build up to it, right? All day long.
Man,
we got here and we saw a game.
We ready to advance, Kate.
Let's keep going.
I'm trying to wait for this thing to finish. You know how that thing that bitch do after the game.
The home crowd in the Thursday opener. And they'll get a few
extra. Yeah, 66.6% completion. That's me. But his was like 30 something. Oh yeah, my boy's got upgrades. Asante Samuel Jr. got upgrades because he had four tackles. Higgins, because he had a reception. Possession. He said, son, that shit was garbage. Who, you? I'm about to text him. Who, you? That dude, I'm getting my laughs on this dude, man. I waited all that time. Waited all that time. Yeah, I'm finished. Let's see the weekly awards. Jamal Adams. What? I see him up there. That boy Von Miller up there. That boy Von Miller does 7 tackles, 3 sacks. I know. I needed to get what I wanted. To get what I need, I needed an outside linebacker. And he about to start decreasing anyways. He already started decreasing his speed and everything. Because he's 33 going on 34. He said a lot of shit that went down was fake as fuck. Huh? Nobody play no user this game this week, huh? Hey, K, bro. I had this Jamaican the other day, bro. Boy. She gave me some of the best head ever. I was like, shit. She was like, baby. Yeah. But I tell you. That addition with Sammy was a good addition for me. We ain't gonna play that again, though. If it's the same results, bro, that's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be the same results because Gordon gonna tote that bitch on. Who that? Oh yeah, that boy gonna be sweet. Is it your running back?
Pressure is on. This one is for the goal.
Yeah.
Hey man, listen, great job today. It's a step in the right direction for you and
us. Okay.
And as long as you keep moving in the right direction, we're gonna
let's go Saints. We want to know now. Let's have a good little practice. Except for one year I started out, the first year I started out slow as hell. You play against Alvin Kamara? Oh shit. But that nigga elusive as fuck, bro. Nigga, I don't care. Nigga, I'm blitzing these niggas. Go get his ass.
Like I said, people in there. There's a couple people in and out. So you know what I'm saying? These niggas get 4 or 5 rounds. Like I said, niggas on my team get old. So.
Right. Gotta give them a certain amount of reps. This nigga go hard in practice and in the game. Bro, it's crazy. I haven't got on my uniform yet. I just realized that shit. I want to see when I play Nut again. I hope it ain't at the end of the season. Shit, I wish I played his ass like week 3, week 4, some shit. Like I'd be playing the Bucks. Damn, y'all already started out high on the high end. Y'all. Ooh, that nigga went deep on my ass. I want to see what Melvin Ingram gonna do against the Bucks, though. God damn. Hold on, okay, I'm coming back. Strong as hell. Huh? This rookie, Higgins, that nigga strong, boy. That nigga broke Marshawn Lattimore tackle like it wasn't nothing. That's what's up. Right. But my D line, this is, bro. Them boys was going hard against Peanut. Y'all gotta be on that bunt. All three of them nice, except for one. He real slow though. Like he do run at 85 speed. Hey, I could use him in like short yardage. If he wide open, I could use him. Slow people need love too, man. Man, the Bucks is a 77 overall team. And we playing at home, and it's another primetime Thursday night game. See, my coach level at a 16. I just got a key in on Mike Evans' ass. Yeah, I started that butt nut season off bad.
Gordon's got
hopefully he bounced back.
And coach, we are down on hopefully the bayou as you get a look inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome here in New Orleans.
Yeah, because I mean, he was happening to me too. And he wanted to restart it just because of that, dude.
Between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the New Orleans Saints.
That's fielded in the because that's how he got that nice little run. He had got a nice little run on me. And I was like, damn. Like, my man was moving slow as fuck. Like, bro, you're not the only one with people that's running slow.
A first carry for Samaje Perine, and he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
All right, Brent, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five.
Ready. Two away. Here we go. Where's that?
Now the first carry for Ronald Jones. And past the 40.
How the fuck y'all let this dude hit the edge?
Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It's going to be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Say, bring that heat.
They'll try to throw now. Winston. And that one got
I should have caught that pick. We tipped that bit.
It brings up third.
Used to have a coach who's
talking about the time. These people crossing
the 50. Just to use up paper, guys. Well, nowadays, you know, we're watching a computer screen, right? They scouted this team very well. Know that they like to use the running backs in the passing game. They covered that play successfully.
He gets it over the middle of Cobb. And they'll get him down as he's inside.
Oh, this who you traded Cobb to.
It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
They've got good playmakers. That nigga just got off of my side of the ball. Like, I don't know 20. What happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a
but
good
his team garbage as hell.
Involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets
out. He said I ain't got nothing to do with that shit.
Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Jameis to throw it.
Sack.
He's going to go down.
Sack.
Near midfield at the 49. Quan Alexander coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8. You know, last week it was unbelievable how many times they were in the backfield. They had 7 sacks. Whatever they had for pregame meal last week, maybe the fan went.
Oh, fumble! Fumble! Get the ball!
But it looks like a Buccaneer was able to correct.
It was a sack and a fumble. Come on, man. Y'all got to be more active.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back.
I'm saying y'all got to be more active. Y'all just got a whole fumble and a sack.
Gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away.
Get that
from
there.
In this case, though,
there
the teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Well, they'll get,
he'll get
15,
fucked over. Oh, okay.
Be nearly enough. It's fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump
just
it
made
underneath
no punt.
There. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, which you're counting on.
I guess the boys heard about your boy in the last game, so they didn't want to kick to that bus.
And pick up the first down.
They can be straight out of bounds. Hope y'all heard about Melvin Ingram because he about to get off on y'all ass. Hope y'all heard about Melvin Ingram. He about to sure about to get business going, y'all. Who?
Now a first carry for Melvin Gordon.
Who?
And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34.
No.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second.
Nah, I ain't
down.
Never get him. Peanut got
this
him.
Running game show.
And he don't much use
them, and they know that. It helped lead him to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity. And that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week. And right now, we're seeing a pattern of that happening.
And he'll get this only up to about the 35.
Yeah, he traded.
It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and four now. They'll run it now out of the gun. And unable to get downhill there, so take this up to about the 37. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down. They're going to try and throw. And Ingram holds it in. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. The numbers a week ago from Melvin Gordon. He was, without a doubt, one of the catalysts in that victory.
And he can really be the glue that makes this offense go, because when defenders have to commit to stopping him, that just opens up more opportunities in the passing game.
They only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and eight forthcoming. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And he'll get down to the 47 here. It's good for a gain of seven, but still a few inches short here with fourth down coming up.
We've seen this offense go for it on fourth down already on this drive. I wonder if they'll go for it again.
You certainly wouldn't rule it out with these guys. They converted once earlier in this drive, but they'll roll the dice here again on fourth down. He'll look to throw.
Damn.
Rushing down he goes. Davis coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of seven. But it was too far for a field goal try. You don't really get a whole lot out of a punt, so I don't think you have much of a problem with that, do you?
No, not at all. I think it's the right play. The exact right play, because even if you want to play defense and pin them deep, you know how hard it is for a punter to knock one dead inside the 10-yard line. That's
that nigga Cobb getting off, for real. That nigga got all the yards on pass.
Going for it there was the right call.
17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
Yeah.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they get it done.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Now he is getting old
on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage too.
Absolutely great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? First time into the red zone for the Buccaneers. It's first and 10 from the 12.
Spread that out.
Here's Piron.
The fuck?
They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Ready? They'll go to Piron, trying to pound it in. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. A great effort there. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. And nothing special there. They show they were going to run the football. They ran it. They got it in.
Like old-time football, right? Hey, this is exactly what we're going to do. Straight-ahead power, and they got it done.
Now the try here for the extra point. Point after, right down the middle.
Shit.
And that makes the score 7-0. So that drive, four plays. And it's capped off by a touchdown run from Samaje Perine. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned him 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down,
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for it. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Looking to throw. That is incomplete.
Shit.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
He's going to look deep down the field. And a hit jarred.
That nigga didn't catch that?
It's incomplete.
Yo, that nigga didn't catch that.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions.
Oh, man, the man on the other side. Gotcha.
Back to throw here. Well, he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down.
You got to get some possession on your ass.
Out of bounds.
That nigga fast, too fast not to be able to catch and keep his feet in bounds.
Normally, I'd say this will lead to a punt attempt, but this offense already shown in the first half that they'll go for it on fourth down.
No, they should have already said punt it. Punt it. Head coach have already made that decision.
This is taken at the 15. It's a 49-yard punt, but subtract 9 there for the return. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10 at their own 24.
That's where we go.
The drive stretch with a handoff to P-Ryan.
Get that ball, man. How that ball busting the tackles like that?
Taken down as that will take us to the
that
end
boy
of
ain't
the
that good.
Play.
Get that.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5.
But I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They got to feel pretty good about that one.
Off the play fake, Winston. Throw right side, caught by O.J. Howard. 23 yards on the play.
And that was a heck of a shot right there by Jameis Winston. Boy, he has a superior right arm, doesn't he? You saw him play baseball.
Yeah, he's actually a switch hitter in baseball. Outfielder, and then, of course, a very hard-throwing pitcher. That's translated well in the extra football league.
That it has. When he has to make that throw out of line, he's got
good play, Green.
To do it.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
See that?
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
He's got his tight end over the middle, O.J. Howard. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
I'm fucking up.
He's up over 50 yards receiving now in his first half. It's a first down.
Fucking up too
much. And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where
you
the kids can't get it.
Man.
It was Taven Bryan who
they
got
already
it
down field position.
Early down stuff to put this offense
already
in
got good field position.
Position
on us.
We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
And he pulls it in for the Buccaneers touchdown.
That
Chicago Feet wasn't involved.
Guys are in for six, and the Bucks are going to add on to their lead. Now the try here for the point after.
Now that touchdown won't allow you to totally relax, but you can breathe a little easier now. Just increased their lead.
Caught a flag on.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. Oh, able to avoid him. And he'll make it across the 20,
man,
as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field.
See, we coming at
already
neck
down
right
two
now.
Touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes
I'm
a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script.
Brown,
I think they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points get that zero off the board. Well, once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's caught inside the 20.
Touchdown.
And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown.
14-7.
77 yards.
I'm down.
And the Saints are able to strike quickly for six. Good start to the season for
got a quick touchdown
last
right
week
quick.
In the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. Then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. Winston and the Bucks take over now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They start on the ground with P-Ron. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold them to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Now P-Ron. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Winston from the gun on 3rd down. It's caught. Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him.
You up?
Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And he takes it down to the 40 with a pickup of 4.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they create some nice space for him.
On 3rd and 1, here's Winston. This is Cobb with a catch right
side. This nigga's way in the backfield.
First down at about the 38. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
And they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now a second down throw for Winston. That's complete to Cobb. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. That catch good for 5. It's third down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to New Orleans after this. The Bucs on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. From the shotgun, it's Winston. And he's
come on, Tassel.
And inside the 20
the before
he's
thinking
brought
about,
down.
Bro? He's got his first catch here before halftime,
and it goes for a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Winston. They'll wind up losing about a dozen on the play, and it'll make this a 2nd and long. Second down, Winston. He finds P. Ryan out of the backfield. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and it's going to be 3rd down and a ways to go here, 3rd and 14.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
3rd and long for Winston. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Rodgers. And now the Saints are going to take a timeout on defense. As the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. And his kick is good. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. So they get 3, certainly hoping for 6 after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Higgins. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. The Saints in a hurry up here. Clock continuing to roll. Out of the gun. They'll look to throw.
I fucked up. Why did I beam it? I almost threw a pick.
Just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
It's been my observation. There's been a nice variety of play calling defensively.
Why?
You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. As the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. He'll drop to throw. He's going to walk one.
Go get it. Go get it.
This is
good catch. Good catch. And way to get out of bounds, rookie.
Will finally be taken out of bounds.
What I'm talking about, baby.
Just before halftime. 43 yards.
Hell yeah.
The defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in the center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from it, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10.
Oh, no, why you going to jump? You had him beat. Why would
this
you jump?
Offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions. Have them looking at 3rd and 10. They'll drop the throw. And the pass is incomplete.
Take the field.
With the clock showing just 3 seconds left.
3 seconds. That's too
so 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And
not in the game. Let me take it on field goal then.
So we have reached half time to go for it. With the Buccaneers out on top. All right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime. Yeah,
I get the ball back, so I get a chance to tie it up.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep.
Bring it back. Ooh.
And he'll get it up to about
if you would have got that block right, boy, that backside was clipped.
Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here at half two, you know?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up. And we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can
pick
it up.
For 9 yards, right quick.
9 yards, and it'll be second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down.
Better run that thing, bro.
37. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Fournette, a first down carry. Looking for an opening.
That nigga
got
get like
he'll get it to the 39. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. On second down, here's Fournette. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. The Saints on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 7.
Bruh, if this defense not in line, okay, that ain't my fault.
He's going to loft one deep inside here.
Ooh, Brown, touchdown. That ball wide the hell open. What the hell happened, y'all? Haskins got his 100th touchdown. Great job. I know you got way more than that. You ain't got to.
Yeah, I'm saying,
you ain't got to say. You're harder than Pete, y'all.
Land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big time performance.
That nigga a monster. That nigga a machine.
In this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And you know, every now and then I actually listen to history class.
And you know, get to win. When you see him, that nigga going automatically throw for 500-600 yards.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
Shit, man. Nigga be scared. Nigga be scared to simp. Nigga be like, man, look, I take my chance of playing the game shit, bro. Nigga be like, I don't want simp. Nigga's gonna beat me by like 40, 50 points.
The Buccaneers offense, they get their first reps of the second half. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Okay, have you ever seen a receiver go across the middle, tip the ball twice, and catch it, and get hit?
Change-ups you might expect, but overall, yeah. You like what your game plan showing you.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28.
Shit crazy.
They'll run it here with B-Rod. Across the 30 to the 32.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw a ball now because usually you have the defense.
Good D, greedy.
Now the
deep ball.
Knocked away and incomplete.
17-17.
So it looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort.
Told you, bro. I ain't playing this year, man.
And brings up a fourth down decision.
Anger is
I can't,
on the
can't afford to be losing like that.
Away. And this will be taken at the 13.
Yeah.
51 yards on the punt there.
I just got the ball back. I made him turn the ball over.
First down.
Let's go.
And 10. And now the Saints get
you winning, you up or you down?
The last possession, these guys are able to tie the game with a touchdown.
Up.
Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there and handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
And that's caught inside the 30. And he gets this down.
Come on, these 7 yard line already.
It's a big play there for
the
Saints.
272 yards passing, 2 touchdowns. No picks.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield.
Yeah, what's
when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive the team towards a victory.
A pickup of 4 on first down. It'll be second and goal. They'll try to punch it in with Fournette. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Come on.
They'll look to throw on third and goal.
Damn. I hate when they do that. When the DBs be switching from side to side, and I be trying to hurry and catch them. They don't want to hurry up, man. Hurry up, man.
They dialed up the blitz on third down, and your worry is a defense.
Shit.
That they can hit you with a big play in that situation. Instead, the blitz pays off. Able to rally to the
tripping,
football,
man.
And make the play.
A field goal would break the tie, but look at this. Instead, they're going to go for it on fourth and goal.
Huh?
Look to throw. And a good turnover there as his guys will get the football back. How about the big boys snagging one? You don't see that every week.
No, you don't, but a lot of them are just reliving their old dreams, going back to when they were in youth football and in high school. They didn't always play defensive line. Some of them actually handled the football, and you can see the flashback when he grabbed that one.
And he'll find some space up to about the 25. And defensive back Jamal Adams in on the stop.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning with the point of attack.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And a tackle there by Quan Alexander.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Jameis to throw it.
Good D, Lattimore.
No interception so far. That probably should have been their first.
Still 17-17.
But at least it's fourth down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Terrific return there, 27 yards all told. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Saints coming out now to take the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
Come on. The ball hit you in the helmet, bro.
Not only did he say
come
that,
on, bro.
But he also
he was wide the hell
in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right?
You got to pay attention, yo.
I know we're being a little bit facetious
he
here,
was
but
wide
the
fuck
bottom
open,
line
kid.
Is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. And they went for a big play through the air on second down, couldn't connect. Now it's third. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. He's going to walk one deep left side here. This is caught.
That's what I'm talking about,
bro.
Making me look bad, throwing all the passes your way, you ain't catching. Catch one.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll set up a throw.
God damn it.
And he'll be brought down.
These motherfuckers jumping routes like a motherfucker.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot in the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
It's P. Ryan to begin the drive. And not much there at all, as he'll get this only up to about the 11. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping.
I told that girl I was going to cook. I might want to order me some goddamn wings.
And move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through.
Let's go. Let's go.
He stopped immediately there. Bud Dupree, a former first-round pick, in on the stop.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Go. On right third down, right Winston. Drops it to Jones.
Let's
in the
go. Pad. Down.
And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15.
And the time rolling down, so it's about to be fourth quarter. So.
And that's going to make it fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And possession.
See, bro, the computer been doing that lately, too, bro. Like the fake punts and fake field goals and shit.
Field position for them here as they come up first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Throw left side, complete to Ingram. And they get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
I might go to wing stop in a little while.
Back now here live in New Orleans.
All I wonder if everybody playing any games so we can go to the next week.
Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. Back to throw. He's going to loft one.
Oh, yeah, Rook. That's what I'm talking about, Rook. Touchdown, baby. Yeah. Yeah.
In for the score. 24-17. Defensively leads to 6 points for the Saints.
I'm telling you, bro, nobody can stick with this dude, bro. See, even the safety.
Extra point, and they will take a 7-point lead.
Nigga can't catch in traffic. But if that nigga open, he catching that bitch. And he got a 98 speed, 97 acceleration. If he don't get past you, something wrong. Huh?
Setting out a kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Buccaneer offense set to take over again. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes just out and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm.
You bought the safety that led the DBs in sacks. That boy came through that, and your boy got rid of that bitch quick. He got that bitch out of there quick. Waste no time.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack?
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't happen at contract time.
Out to the left there, and complete to Howard. And he'll get it up to
the 33. He didn't get that first down. It's 32. Let's go. You got to stop him again.
Set up a third down.
There's a complete to the tight end, and
gonna try to go
I think
to the
that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely.
I mean, size, hands, speed.
Are they running that bit?
Run. You put that whole package together, you light
it
up
is that.
Of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
Yeah, they get him
shit,
down.
That boy got 16 rushes for 75 yards and a touchdown.
Line. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
See, right in that fire blitz at. Of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few
Right in that paint of that bump, man.
Three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be
right in that paint of that bump, man.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
And once again, hit is unfortunate.
Let's go.
Wound up incomplete. It's a loss of four. Now third down. The Bucs on third down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This is third and 14. Working out of the gun, Winston.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Give me the ball back, man.
As he was throwing it.
I'm about to punt that bit back.
that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet won't necessarily reflect in ours, right, the overall game sheet. But you and I know that they keep count on pressures, hits on quarterbacks, all those things, hoping to increase that throughout the game. And here we are in the fourth quarter, and they got a big one.
Yeah, it's such a close game, a very big one. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. They're holding on right now.
No, don't tell me they're going straight man across the board. Oh, man, he went to burn the fuck out of
this. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
Well, this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. The reception good for seven. It's third down. He'll look to throw. He's going to wind up.
Oh, he got it. He got him. He blew clean by him. Touchdown, baby. You know what I'm talking about, Rook? I got a new favorite target. This is fifth touchdown this season. This is fifth on the season.
So on third and medium, they dial up the pass.
So last game, he had three touchdowns.
It's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is.
Trying to get him three touchdowns this game.
But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of
those. Trying to get Rook on the same level with Brown.
They took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
If I get him.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone.
But if I can get him on the same level, that's going to be him.
Now the Buccaneer
your boy Samuel and
Brown. And right
all
now
three of them
struggling a little bit, maybe doubting because three straight drives have ended with him punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
False start. Offense.
Yeah, boy, so nervous on the line.
Maybe anticipating a blitz, and they jumped.
Yeah, and if we saw it, you know that they saw it. The bad guys might have been covered on that play.
They still gave him an upgrade.
Pick them up, and they jumped.
From the gun, Winston. Throw left side complete. It's Howard. And he's able to get up here to the 26. 6 yards.
It's 31-17. Not good.
At this stage, this drive's got to be touchdown or bust because you need two of them.
And if I'm the offensive play caller, I'm not just looking at my dagger plays downfield. I'm looking at some of my specials, something that can fool and give you a big play now.
With a sense of urgency.
No doubt.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Seven catches for him now, and this last one, a first down. But correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to 42-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Winston now. This is Cobb with a catch.
That boy Adams active as hell.
That throw good for four. It's second down. Those short little routes probably going to be open. The defense, they'll let those happen, especially when they can make an inbounds tackle.
Yeah, where's Coach Madden when you need him? He always talked about taking what the defense gives you, but sometimes you have to know when you have to take more. That was one of those situations.
Sack. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards.
No, we got more than two sacks, because I just had two sacks before I made this one.
The Bucs on third down. They've converted five times in their many chances thus far. This is third and nine. Now Winston. A dump underneath the Jones. So a good spin move
punt the ball to me, y'all.
He's taken down. A nice little game. 7 yards on the play.
Oh, yeah,
and it'll be fourth down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch. Inbounds. Keep the clock running. Just go ahead and
run back field.
P. Ryan denied on fourth down. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. So now with a little over 2 minutes to play, the road back gets very difficult.
difficult, man, but still not impossible if they go ahead and play this thing out. Now the defense has to come up big. They've got to go for a strip of the football on each and every snap to try and give themselves a chance.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Hey,
do you think?
Stop made there by Gerald McCoy. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. On second down, they run the court. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here.
By the safeties, bro.
They'll look to throw. He's going to walk one deep left side here. And this is
touchdown again. He got another touchdown.
Into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A big play there.
Yeah.
47 yards. And the forced fumble defensively leads to 6 points for the Saints.
We're not in his feelings right now, so. I'm winning 38-17.
And the lead now to 3 touchdowns to 21. Pretty clean and simple there. Just 2 plays. The long pass resulting in the touchdown.
I ain't trying to lose no games this year.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
Perfect season. Perfecto.
5 on the 50.
The first down throw for Winston. Man open right side. It's
make that ball fumble, Adams.
And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
Well, he's doubling it up on Howell. Go ahead.
Now a second down throw for Winston. Over the middle. It's caught by Rodgers.
1 minute and a half left.
And able to get this one across
the 45. Ain't gonna lie, Winston, he's doing good. He's 23 for 29.
That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Winston out of throw on first down.
And you got so many sacks on him, dude. Think you got sacks on his ass.
They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Second down, Winston. Throw right side, caught by O.J. Howard. As we'll get a timeout as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. Third and long for Winston.
Sack.
And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down.
But Jamal got 6 tackles
and
2 sacks.
They're going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. He's got his tight end over the middle, O.J. Howard. And he's not able to get away.
Again. Trying to get him another touchdown.
Well short of a first down.
Trying to get him so on that boy level quick.
For pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was
trying
already
to get Brown level
no
quickly.
Doubt about it. This one was over a
while every time, that safety always bite over towards that tight end because that tight end's out there. He's done.
That one looks like he'll throw here. He sets the fire deep.
Like I just said, kid.
And he is into the end zone.
Brooke having a season already.
A big play there.
44-17.
Yards. And the Saints add on 45-17. Looking like they're well on their way to a 2-0 start. All smiles right now on that sideline, isn't it?
As well there should be. It's hard to win a game in the NFL. We hear it all the time. We know that it's difficult. But guess who's smiling? But inside is thinking 24-hour rule because we're going to play again next week,
boss man.
Oh, without a doubt. The head coach, he wants him to feel good, but at the same time, find a way to keep improving.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Buccaneers' offensive unit back out on the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
If you don't play by the end of the night.
Some people like to do that.
I remember playing for a guy once who was huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to
pick that off, Adams. That's another possession for us.
First down, it's knocked away and incomplete.
Pick that shit off, Adams.
Well, that's a perfect example of how he was named NFC Defensive Player of the Week from last week's game. He is just all around the football right now, isn't it?
That he is, and it's funny because I talked with the coaching staff about drills that they do in practice, and one of them is called...
Oh, another pick. I just spoke it up. Quan Alexander got another pick.
Picked up by Quan Alexander, and he'll wind up losing 5 yards or so on the return, but no matter, they've got the football back.
Damn.
This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
Back to throw now on second and 10. In trouble, and he's taken down.
That's all I need.
And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. It's just their first.
And
they've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Safety over there. About to get him tied up.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to walk one deep left side. It's caught inside the 25. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10.
I got you next game.
They're going to look to throw. And nearly picked off.
Nice defense, y'all.
Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away. But it does get away, and it's second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Now a second down throw
right in your hands,
for the end zone, but it's incomplete. And it's incomplete. Still time left, though. 2 seconds remaining now in the fourth quarter.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to stop.
Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line.
Why is it a...
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they?
Harmon ain't no rookie goal, man.
To put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and
clicking. But I'm in the NFC, though.
Nah, MVP is the whole league.
Oh, well, I don't know if you're going to get MVP. I ain't saying all that. Ooh, these niggas got upgrades. Kawhi, Jordan, the rookie receiver, and Wilson, my D-tackle. Yeah, but we're talking about he got a 91 overall team. What? I told him, I said, what? That boy said I had to start the game over. I had the wrong playbook. He was down 21-7. Hey, for real. Check my stats out. threw for 593, a 109.3 quarterback rating. 6 touchdowns, 2 interceptions. I got sacked 3 times. I went 16 for 32, yo. My rushing yards didn't do nothing. I didn't do nothing with rushing. I mean, wasn't tripping about that. But them boys had 17 rushes for 75 yards. Say, your boy, the Rook, 7 receptions, 337, 4 touchdowns. That boy come from Auburn, too. None of their receivers got touchdowns. Brown got 2 touchdowns. Brown got 3 receptions, 207 yards, 2 touchdowns. Huh? Who's that? Damn. Yeah, man. That boy's fast, man. That boy gets jiggy with it. That little nigga go through that safety bite over to the middle, just about a yard or two, he burnt. He's not catching it. You see my touchdown? About to look at, cause I was looking at the stats, like the game stats. Right now. Yeah. 7. Brown got 3. No, hold up. I gotta go to the NFL. I got 7. Harmon got 4. Taylor got 4. Peebles got 3. And Brown got 3. But my boy Brown right behind you. Look, Peoples Jones, Brown, Samuel. Ah, McCaffrey right here with 2. Nah, Samuel's before him. For me? Curtis Sam? Yeah, because he got 9. Because he got 9 receptions for 124. Hey, but Rook going ham.
But you see that boy Taylor? That's my Rook.
See, that your boy leading in sacks.
What a rusher, nigga. Oh, you on defense, man?
Nah. Okay. Fucking do big day sumo. Yeah. Like Uno. Like Judo. You back to Kudo. You and her no chance, Hugo. I'm number 3 in rushing. I'm right behind both of your backs. Both of them boys. Oh, you got JJ Taylor. No wonder why. That nigga a beast. He a straight beast. Okay, we all doing something with love over there. Curry keeps the plane calling, Brent Zuko. Swimming through the money like a founder. Hold up. I just want the knowledge and the power. Hold up. Why didn't every shower? Am I still a 78? Rider. Am I still a 78 overall? When I gave him to him, he was a 78. Yeah. When I gave him to him, he was a 78. Yeah. But he would still be a 78. Though. Because he just wasn't using it when he came back. Like, Shaq at the free throw. Anybody wanna be ET? Man, y'all can't see me. Out of my leave you pee when you die. Pocket through beer, I kiss you. Pocket through beer, that's Uno. Pulling apart like Uno. I'm about to shoot up. Like Pluto. Watch when the playoffs come around. Playoffs? Hold up, I don't want to see nothing nowhere in the top right here for quarterbacks. Yeah, he only played one game, but still, a lot of these quarterbacks didn't play just one game. 263, yeah, and four picks. 43% completion. Yeah. Nigga, I was coming for his hat. I was coming for his hat. Money on my mind just like a tumor. Spread my money out and then I call it a rumor. Current is on the moon, no Uber. People try to block it, shine like lunar. Eclipse, wanna take all my chills, wanna pop off the... And I'm talking about, I had to go find that boy. That boy way down there. I'm a flip, money flow like a battleship, Diddy the new, deal of a new. He ain't gonna be running for the top this year unless he get a team he play against, but he threw up like 900 some yards pass. Man, y'all can't see me. Out of my league, you peewee. Pocket to beat Rakishi. Pocket to beat that sumo. Pulling on like Uno. Flip like Pluto. Yeah. You back to Kudo. You and her no chance, you go. Pocket to beat that sumo. Pocket to beat that sumo. Pocket to beat that sumo. Oh, you know that rookie played for Trevor Lawrence. He played for the Broncos. He ain't throw no picks yet, son. I know I ain't gonna be leading the NFC in rushing yards after this week, because I ain't rushed with Melvin Gordon none this week. I ain't really rushed with him. I started throwing the ball all game. Yeah, Zeke and Saquon.
Yeah, if you get off.
I ain't worried about Kevin, Kieran Johnson, and Ty Gurley. Ty Gurley, maybe if you have a good game. And Dalvin Cook. Would you chase that? It's a never-ending run on this racetrack. No matter what, I'ma stay black. That nigga AJ Brown is a fool. Need more jewelry. What I tell myself as I'm writing my eulogy. Ask the mirror, how you put up with this foolery? In reply, how you put up with this song and dance? Let me go look at my schedule, see what my schedule looking like. Man's death, what it do to me? Yamagini dream was a nightmare. He was dancing with the devil for his life, yeah. We all on the dance floor. Nigga, I think I'm gonna move into a one bedroom. Puerto Rican in the breathing heavy. Little am I looking daddy? Couldn't tell him none cause we lost him already. Cozy boy with his spaghetti. With the money and fame, the price come heavy. I got the Panthers next. Bye week. The Bills, Panthers, Cowboys, Cardinals, Bucks. Dang, I don't play peanut until week 16. I play against that boy AJ Brown. First class, not what you went to. You need to really chase money like you saying. How did you the boat change? You gotta play against him in 2 weeks. Because I play the Panthers, then I got a bye week, the Bills, then the Panthers again, the Cowboys, the Cardinals, the Bucks, Dolphins, Patriots, Redskins, Giants, Packers, Eagles, Falcons, Jets. Got a nice little schedule. You can never get rid of me. Got a venue, both of our five venues. Yo, you play against that boy Trevor Lawrence next.
Okay.
Hey. Hey. I ain't folding under pressure. I ain't switching. Hello.
I ain't talking to no captain. I ain't telling on my bros. Ain't no that don't push me fingers. Looking on that.
Okay, everything all right?
Yeah, just a hit the screw
told me that earlier. I thought you was taking him.
Huh?
You told me that earlier. I thought you was taking him then. You driving right now?
Huh?
You driving right now? Alright, let me know.
Hold it down so we'll all be living large. And it's crazy how last year was on my garage. Now I'm in a good position for this life, can't sabotage. I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no. I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling all my bros. Ain't no but don't push me fingers itching on that. Plotting on my come up, gotta watch stay at my nose. Long nights I'm just to hit the studio. Now me and steak and shrimp.
Man, you know what I wish this Madden thing was like? You could go through your whole season without messing with somebody else's season. If, even if y'all are in the same league, and they just play their games all the way to the playoffs, and you just wait for them at the end. For real. I would have had a couple of seasons, a few seasons to go with. I could play like 6 games in 1 day. I could play probably a whole season in 1 day.
Go.
Oh, that boy played against the Giants. Peanut. Oh, Mike has some issues.
Let's
see what he has. Giants got. Giants got Teddy Bridgewater starting that quarterback. And he got Tyrod Taylor as the backup. Then he got Josh Allen as a backup too. They got Saquon. They got Swift, the dude from Georgia. And they got Wayne Gallman Jr. They got Calvin Ridley at receiver. Tyrell Williams. Rashad Perriman. Corey Coleman. And they got the little rookie at receiver. Then they got Austin Hooper. He traded Austin Hooper to them. Then they got the rookie from Ohio State. They offense alignment nice. They not all. Not all of them. What the hell? Their right tackle suspicious as fuck.
Yeah, this got me thinking.
They right tackle. The Giants right tackle got a 69 overall. Swerving through traffic. Listening to traffic. My windows ain't tinted, so notice me. Oh, I traded Vic Beasley to them. Vic Beasley joining to them. But I'm still attentive. A young with money will make. Did I know? Oh no, Peanut had him. Peanut traded to him. Cause he was getting them draft picks. That's hungry and eager. My brother's keeper, I'm loyal. It's all in my demeanor. A true believer. Lorenzo Carter. They didn't believe her. That's why I don't let opinions affect me. I do what I want to do. If they do what they want, they expect me to give up. Almost did. Things went from moving faster. Slow motion. I was losing focus. Stuck on that. It was smooth on the surface, but underneath it was broken. Hoping to find hope in this hopeless world we live in. What you give is what you're given. Gotta make wise decisions. Gotta stay tunnel vision. Gotta avoid collision. Keep scratching the surface and keep your palms itching. Gotta pay moms a visit. It's been a while. They're gonna have problems with this team. She keep telling me she misses. She like to throw deep. And they got some safeties. Then I spin around. She say I'm always moving. Ma, I just can't sit around. Oh my. Bro, they got this safety. I'm trying to get him from now. He's 75 overall, 24 years old. He 92 speed, 91 acceleration, 90 agility. His zone is 79. Man is 71. And we're about to catch any tackle. Trying to stay true to welcome from the youth. Even when they lie, 73 tackles. My shoulders, my girl can't even cry on me. God watching over me, the devil probably spy on me. I've been going through some. Can of keep an eye on me. I know it's been a drought, but to my fans, don't go dry on me. If you want a picture, take a picture. Don't get shy on me. I'm here to inspire. I admire that you admire me. I've been in the dark, but I promise you'll see it right of me. I'm sorry.
To all my supporters, man. I love y'all.
Yeah, that butt brown.
I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one.
Shit, they got Eric Reed. Win, man.
I don't know why. And then he got Ha-Ha Clinton Dix. The cornerbacks are kind of suspicious, but 79 stick a pass. They still be balling. Everybody clear the room. I like to ride alone. I'm in my zone. Base bouncing. Now I'm talking about some 79 corners. They still be balling. I'm either hot or cold. Depending on how you play. Now see, yeah. But this is the thing, for what Peanut do, right? Peanut, he gotta actually play, cause he play against the Redskins too. I swear my life was like a rocket, then it takes off. First I plotted, then I got it, couldn't wait long. I put the pedal to the metal, then took the brakes off. And I kept an A1 like the steak sauce. My paychecks used to be a pair of Jordans, and I know I can't afford them, but I went ahead and bought them. Then I quit, started, spent my money on recording. Yeah, the studio was small, but man, that made me a fortune. Huh? Made me a fortune, man.
Who?
Trying to stop me.
Y'all can't stop me. This is forever.
I'm about to see right now.
Forever, man. I mean that.
He ain't make no trade.
What's that on that beat?
Addicted to balling. Oh, did he? To get my cash. The money is calling. Got bands. I'm addicted to balling. I'm addicted to balling. I like to get my hands. I pull up in my pants. Flexing, counting my bands. Started getting money. I see how it feels to be rich. I live by the beach now. That's how I should live. Since I was a toddler, I knew that I would become this. I cannot move slow. That's a big, big no. Gotta chase this money. Bankroll after.
So who you talking about?
I must get this money. I must get this money. I know he traded Jalen Richard and his second round pick and his cornerback, Jordan Lewis, to the Colts. And he got a guard. A guard for them three. Started let me too quick. With the Oakland with a few. Took him out your break. Yeah. Imagine what I paid for the Rollie. Still from the police. 24. Yeah, I don't see nothing about no tree. You must did it last year. For the homies. Nice little cornerback on your practice squad. Yeah, that boy got 73 strength. Yeah, man.
I know.
I've been and put that boy in strong safety. That boy, 73 strength, that strong safety strength. Yeah. Well, he's nice, but his strength still like a 68. Still high. Look, yeah. One in the head, one in the back, bubbling. Look at the cash coming in. Come get your man slim. Man, the bug Bucks got somebody on the practice squad as a free safety. My passion deep in our rating. We act the fool for the paper. Had a dream and I made it. El Camino on Dayton's. Bitches guess over bait. Put the bread on me. Bet on my bacon. Pick it flat in the bacon. I might just roll out today. I might just roll out to Vegas. Head back to my old ways. Cop a roof on you. All day. Look at me, baby. Look at me, baby. Don't I look like a million? I'm about to clean out the safe. Don't I look like somebody that just be bodying and everything? All that talking is great, but I don't be talking. I air it out. All the problems have gotten easy to bury. I'd rather kiss on my... I've been broke way longer than I've been rich, so until it levels out, I'ma take mama to the Marriott. Took me so long to get it, gotta spread it out. Let them know all about me when I'm dead and gone. One in the hand, one in the bag, brother. One in the hand, one in the bag, brother. Look at the cash, look at the cash, brother. Look at the cash, brother. One in the hand, one in the hand. One in the hand, one in the bag, brother. Look at the cash, look at the cash, brother. Look at the cash, brother. I'm gonna need all the fries you can give me, all the hot sauce, all the pie you can give me. Better be all or nothing, don't have me in the middle. You better be all you can, yeah, you can limit. Yeah. Super fly for the Dumbos, clean slides like a shuffle. 50K's on my young girl, Isaac Hayes been the ocean. About the old home with the cane stick, let my slippers at the function. It's hard to run the Gucci slides, that bet you say you didn't ever. I'ma stand up, Jackie Chan, no travel. Can't keep it with the bees, dripping from the... No, no, not me. I can never be the one you want to stuff for. Money, money, the machine. The bell got my stuff. I'll repeat the times that I was broke. I've been like a 9-11, folks. Mad back, lick it clean. That place is here and I'm a local. Cooking up tonight. Waiting for the antidote. Running out of time. Pictures thinner than a penny, ho. One in the hand, one in the bag, brother. One in the hand, one in the bag, brother. Look at the cash, look at the cash, brother. Look at the cash, brother. One in the hand, one in the bag, brother. Look at the cash, look at the cash, brother. Look at the cash, brother.
Johnny Big Redemption, like, know what I'm talking about? Hold up.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah.
Yeah.
Get out the way, get out the way, get out my way, yeah.
Yeah.
You either with me or against me, though. You either with me or
win.
Win, 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 win.
Yeah.
Curve everything else. Win, 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 win.
Win.
These ops ain't. Tattoos, that's squad, 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 squad. All of them go, don't try, 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 try. I walk in room, they eyes wide, wide, wide. Third album come soon, I'm glad y'all gon' die. I ain't chasing after no, no. I got bigger plans than staying rich. I been tap dancing since I was 6. I tap dance all on them. And your diamonds like tap water. That drip way too foggy. These BBS is way awesome. Pork CLS with... Drop to your death without warning. Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah.
Yeah.
Get out the way, get out the way, out my way, yeah.
Yeah.
You either with me or against me, though.
It was a nice so send this beat, I'll play later.
Win, 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 win.
Yeah.
Curve everything else. Win, 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 win.
Win.
These ops ain't. Win, 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 win. Start chasing that. Clowns really don't stay outside when I plow outside. I put the beats on.
on them like Dre outside. I got the bow side and LA outside. And if you act bad, I bring the outside. Go and get your money. None of my don't sit funny.
I can tell you about who you're running with. I'm on the field, duck lunch, hit my just a,
and he was like, boop.
Here.
Knew just what it was, the hug, but gave it back, boop.
Yeah.
9-11, no malice, baby. But no violence, baby. My got callous, baby. My bare knuckles got talent, baby. I'm all in, well, no in with it. On deuce line, I've been with it. She too fine, I've been. Crashed two times, I limo tinted my new ride.
See, he was riding with the 12 at yeah. Me. See, I was trying to play my game, mister.
Nothing to
see, you on Ultimate Team right now.
Get out the way, get out the way.
The rookie linebacker I got from LSU, about 82 overall, 87 speed, 88 acceleration, 85 agility, 78 strength. His awareness is a 72, play recognition 73, tackling a 90, power hit 89, block shed 78, power move 79, his man coverage a 72. Pursuit at 82, zone at 79, and the catching at 65, jumping at 81. Shit, that nigga active as well. His confidence went up 5 points. Cause I never knew I'd get my chest to lick up. Oh, I tell you all of this and use your rule of me. Swear I came from the bottom, flappers living, walking dead on. Put your favorite rapper's name up on the headstone. Big with the cheese and your dad wrong. Propaganda said the standards in your tear down. Throw it back, yeah, I'm born to. It's talking, it's hot, so leave me where I'm at. I'm living how I wanna. No reason looked out, it's clear to see. All eyes on me, 400 degrees. Coming to me about government jobs and shit. Does it, in public, hated and love it. The underdogs, we look swabs. It was written in my diary to start a war. I'm feeling infamous, immortal with my technique. A revolution, a part-time job when I get out. Young Don Cartagena, excuse my demeanor. Just the glamour life is still not a player. Take you part ain't time, shit. I'm born again, life back to death. I made the sacrifice and super duper fly. Used to keep them hypnotized. I said my name is Shoot. America's most. Ain't no half step and see you at the cross. Okay, truck drive, CDL, classic. Southeast regional. Only take a when I put up this. I'm gang three times on my head stop.
It was written in the children's story. Their life's a so what you want? Every day I struggle with it. Only God could tell me slipping. I'm infinitely big.
And they got lift drop on. See, for real though, that might be my job for a little while. Just driving for lift. For the cream, renegade. For the money, only green is the green. Make pretty good on that shit, too. Huh? Can I live? Still filming, just a death from a chicken neck. Green,
green,
get your ass caught up quick. See, I had brought one little chick to a hotel room. She told me, she said, have you ever had fun with one of your riders before? I was like, what you mean fun? Like going out fun? But she was like, nah, silly. She was like, I mean like fun. I was like, yeah, a few times. She was like, you want to try with me? I was like, yeah, let's go.
Single life feels so good.
Here I go to the
next episode. I almost think I want to settle down, man. Explosive Beast Coast. Yeah. Might happen soon. I don't know. It depends on what happens. Yeah, a lot of teams need quarterbacks. Like, what the fuck? Might be willing to trade one to him for a little small price. It's gonna cost you. Keenum. And they stand. Man, fuck y'all. And then y'all got quarterback as y'all number one. Man, y'all don't need him. Now the Giants, they need a quarterback, but he the same overall as Teddy Bridgewater. So I'm hard headed like the juggernaut, but there ain't nothing I can do to listen. I'm authentic and I walk around like I just ate, but let you do the dishes. I'm Clark Kent, but mix the auto box and mix with everything that you've been missing. Please get back and don't get that involved. Freaking sick, I'm about to make him a nice little deal. I'm the king, heavy clown, heavy rain, cat and dog. Hold me with me if you ask him. I'm gonna give him he be asking for him. He just wanna have a better call. The quarterback, Leonard Fournette. No, I have somebody else extra. And that linebacker, I just got off the who was a DN as a 68. I put him at linebacker here, 71. And the green, the quarterback green, then the Fournette yellow. And I want Saquon Barkley. They did it. They took it. So I got Saquon, Melvin Gordon, and my rookie, and another rookie. Saquon starting. Melvin Gordon behind him. But Peanut gonna really be scratching his head. That boy Nut better really be scratching his head, because I really didn't hurt myself in no way. I took people that was like backups. And I still got Josh Jackson as my quarterback, as my backup quarterback. And my little fullback, he didn't got better too. He was a 70, a 65, and now he's a 70. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that hero fail, get my baby 35. Hell yeah. I just need to build up on this offensive line. You know what? All I'm gonna use is three running backs. I'm on the road, I'm getting dead. I want you all, baby. You a bush baby, but love you, baby. Give you the world, baby.
That's swear, baby, we just cause nice. How could I forget that you done done for me? Baby, gonna take the charge and take the fall for me. Would love to take you shopping, but girl, I'm in your car. Sorry, little mama, I can give you more. Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now.
Alright, got me a 21-year-old right guard from the Bucks. Higgins been got better. My rookie. I got, how many rookies I got? I have receivers. One, two, three. I got three rookie receivers. All three of them, well, two of them caught passes. I gotta get St. Brown to catch some passes. That boy's slow, though. Yeah. I think I might get rid of that. Where you came from? That boy came from USC. Wonder why, no wonder. They were catching the 87. Catching in traffic 85. Short route running 89. Medium 80. Spectacular catch. Right. Keeping your ass. But what's his agility? His agility. His agility at 87. Acceleration 86, speed 85. Alright, I can work with you, bro. I'll work with you. His break tackle 75. I'm just working on my possession. Like whenever he gets up, we're getting possession. But that boy, that's gonna be up. Pulling his hair when he see I got Saquon Barkley and Melvin Gordon.
Sounds like I see it's in that. Hey, I'm on your turf again.
I gotta open it up. I gotta open up the playbook, kid.
I got a girl, Brett. She put a battery. I let it blow the tent. I go in back of the. They all from it. My diamonds, they all look at. I go to bed on bed. I got the demon on flat. I got a in the back.
Hey, right. By mid-season, they should be straight.
I'm a cave back. I'm a cage. I found out where you lay. I got the lurking and they hate cats. I can stay fat. I got the people in the block and they scamming. They know what banks at.
That's a lot.
I got the Brooklyn the Avenue. They know what tanks at. I got the living the mansion. They know what that. I got some that's up in the jail. They know what that. I came on top of the building. Yeah, my we had a plan. We came on top of the building. Yeah, my we never ran. Down there, thought that I had a fan. Oh, hey, any 10 o'clock, got a flight out. Yeah, I'm going back out to Japan. I got two Billy truck and a bitch door with a lamp. Bruce Wayne, I'm Batman. Batman, I'm best man. I got my best man. I got my. I go to hotels when I step out. Yeah, your boy got a doorman. I go to nightclubs with a. Yeah, they call me the madman. I ain't no madman. I just go crazy, man. Ball hard, can't face, man. Choppers, rip wasteland. This what happens when you give it a taste life, then you give it a wasteland. This what happens when you give it a fake life, then the ape in. I live with birds, man. Sounds like I see it's in there. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that, yeah. From the back of the. I got a girl, Brett. Yeah. She put a better shit. Yeah. I live with birds, man. Sounds like I see it's in there. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that,
yeah. I doubt from the back of the. Seriously doubt it.
Yeah, you playing the Rams? You down 3-0?
Oh, shit. I had